Hello, my name is Dave Kessler, and I'm going to talk to you about handling excess zeros with PROC FMM. To begin with, let's clarify what I mean when I say excess zeros. In this setting, we mean there are more zeros than expected for a distribution. When you model with a distribution such as the Poisson, you predict a certain number of zeros given the values of the predictors in your model. If the observed values of your data have more zeros than the model predicts, you have excess zeros. So you have excess zeros. Why is this a problem? Well, distributions like the Poisson, binomial, and negative binomial have strict relationships between the mean and the variance. One cannot move without the other. When you go through the estimation process, both the mean and the variance will be affected by your data. You're trying to estimate both quantities, and if the data do not fit well with the model, you'll see distortions in your estimates. Now, what's PROC FMM? The procedure name is shorthand for Finite Mixture Models. The strength of PROC FMM is in fitting mixtures of distributions so that you can create more flexible models. This seems like a nice aspiration, but how does it help you with excess zeros? Consider this example, which uses credit card application data. The response in this model is the number of major derogatory reports, or MDRs. What are major derogatory reports? These are serious negative elements of a credit history, like a foreclosure or an account that's referred to a collection service. From the point of view of a credit card issuer, an applicant with a predicted number of MDRs that is high is less attractive as a credit risk. Here's a view of the organization of the data and one record. The other variables in the data set, which you will use as explanatory variables, have some relationship to the outcome of interest, the number of MDRs. A good first step in any analysis is to do some visualization, and this histogram of the MDRs shows that many of the applicants have zero MDRs. This is probably not surprising because all these people have gone to the trouble of providing personal financial information in hopes of obtaining a credit card. They have probably pre-selected themselves as good credit risks. Now you can start with the actual modeling. Because these are count data, you can use the Poisson model. You'll use the explanatory variables in the data to predict the number of MDRs. You'll also assess the fit of this model. You see here the fit statistics for the Poisson model. The last fit statistic in the table, the Pearson statistic, should be close to the sample size. Recall that was 1,319, and it is much larger than that. This indicates overdispersion in this model. You can get a sense of the overdispersion by comparing the observed and predicted proportions of different counts. The bar chart indicates that the model has underpredicted the number of zeros. Also, because the predictions must go somewhere, the model has overpredicted other counts, the number of ones and twos. You've seen that the data have excess zeros for the Poisson model, but what can you do about it? Maybe you can think of these data as being generated by two underlying groups of people. One of these groups will have at least one MDR, and the other group will have zero MDRs. Think of them as the sometimes and never groups. There is nothing hidden about these groups. You can identify them by their number of MDRs. What you can do is model this sample with a hurdle model. An individual must get over some hurdle before registering at least one MDR. This hurdle model is a mixture of two processes, one that generates non-zero counts and the other that generates only zero counts. And so you're about to see PROC FMM's purpose for existing. You saw that PROC FMM can fit the Poisson model, and indeed it can fit other generalized linear models. But the distinctive feature of PROC FMM is its ability to fit finite mixture models. A finite mixture model is one that combines two or more individual distributions into a new distribution. Instead of using a completely non-parametric approach, you can use this semi-parametric approach to model data with increased flexibility, but still have models with a parametric form. Now you can fit the hurdle model in PROC FMM. You see two model statements, one for each component in the mixture model. The first is a truncated Poisson distribution. This is like a Poisson distribution, but it models only counts greater than or equal to one. The second component is a constant. It just generates zeros. Finally, there is a prob model statement that describes how the two components are mixed together. In this case, you include some of the explanatory variables in the prob model. You examine the fit statistics just as you did with the Poisson model. You can see that the Pearson statistic is still large relative to the number of observations in the data. In this case, maybe truncation is not the right strategy. You can also fit a zero-inflated Poisson or ZIP model by using PROC FMM. The ZIP is like a hurdle model, but both components can generate zero counts. The difference is that the first component is a regular Poisson model as compared to the hurdle model, which used a truncated Poisson. Once again, you can look at the fit statistics to assess how well this model is doing. This is still better than the Poisson, but it's not quite as good as the hurdle model. So what other models are available? You can also fit a zero-inflated negative binomial, or ZINB model. This is like any of the other zero-inflated models, but it uses a negative binomial component in addition to the constant component. The attraction of the negative binomial component is that it has an additional scale parameter that provides more flexibility in the mean variance relationship. The fit statistics for the ZINB model indicate a very good fit. The Pearson statistic is very close to the number of observations, and all the other fit statistics have improved as well. Here is a visualization of the four models you fit, comparing the difference between the observed counts and the predicted counts. The ZINB is the best model across all the levels. So what have you learned today? You can use mixture models to approach problems with apparent excess zeros. PROC FMM provides several options for this situation, including the hurdle model, the ZIP model, and the ZINB model. As you investigate other situations, you can use PROC FMM to create flexible models. And of course, with better models, you get better predictions and better decisions. If you'd like to read more about the data used in this example, here's a reference. Thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this presentation.